Microsoft revealed the retirement date for Windows 10 in an updated support lifecycle page for the OS. After which there were many rumors regarding next Windows, namely called Windows X, Windows 11. It's now confirmed that next Windows OS will be Windows 11. Windows 11 has been in the spotlight recently, not for its release but for the massive leak that has allowed users to try out the new OS ahead of the launch. Microsoft had been gearing up to talk about the next generation of Windows on June 24. I am installing Windows 11 on VMware. Here you will see there the new logo of Windows. The installer has the same UI as Windows 10. The setup UI is new over here, which is much better than previous one, and most annoying this is now removed Cortana. Now my Windows is configured. Windows 11 is getting ready, and here also you can see new blue glowing animation added to the background. Here it's almost ready. Presenting you the new Windows 11. Let's move forward and see what's new in Windows 11. New visuals in Windows 11. One of the changes you're most likely to notice are the new icons in the File Explorer. Icons for folders have changed, including colorful ones for the default system folders. The Downloads folder is green with the download icon, for example. The Desktop folder looks just like a miniaturized desktop environment. There are also new icons for hard drives and a few other things here and there. Outside of File Explorer, some system apps also have new icons, like Windows Security, Notepad, the Task Manager, and Narrator. Other eye-catching thing is rounded UI, if you ever notice that. Improved Settings app. The Settings app now has a few new capabilities, including some that were only available through the Control Panel. The storage section accessed through system. Storage has the most improvements. Disk management has been integrated into the settings app, as has the storage spaces feature. These let you manage the drives connected to your PC. Microsoft has added a new advanced view that lets you see additional drives. Back to the settings app, the graphics settings. System. Display. Graphics settings have been made a bit easier. This page will now auto-populate with apps on your PC so you can choose which GPU to use for each one. You can still add more apps manually, though. Moving on to sound. you can now set devices as your default audio input and output devices from the Settings app. This setting is available under System Sound Manage Sound Devices. Finally, for those with accessibility needs, the caption settings have been streamlined. You'll now see quick, easy to understand default settings, and you can create a new custom profile if you prefer. These settings are available under Accessibility Captions. On that note, accessibility is the new name for the section that used to be called Ease of Access. Task Manager Improvements. The Task Manager now displays which architecture is used by each of your apps. In the Details tab, you'll see a new architecture label, which will specify if a given process is x86, x64, or ARM. Using Virtual Desktops. Virtual Desktops is an easy-to-use feature in Task View designed to help you organize related activities into groups. Using this feature, you can create multiple environments that each can run different apps, keeping your focus on a particular project. Typically, this feature comes in handy to keep work tasks separate from your personal tasks, or when multitasking between different activities, and you don't have a multi-monitor setup. Improved App Snapping Experience. On Windows 11, Microsoft is adding some nice additions to the snapping UX. To begin, there's a new super handy snapping grid menu that drops down when a user hovers their cursor over the app window maximize button. This drop-down menu allows you to snap the app you're using to a particular position in one of the grid layouts that Microsoft has built into Windows 11. On small screens, you get four layouts to choose from, totaling in 11 different snapping areas to select. On devices with a large display, you get an additional two layouts, which totals to 17 different snapping areas to select. And many more features are there on which Microsoft is working on. Join to see what's next for Windows. Watch the live stream on June 24, 2021 at 11 a.m. Eastern Time, hashtag Microsoft Event. Comment your favorite feature of Windows 11. Thanks for watching.